Well, shoot. Somebody said that they wanted to go on a High Sierra adventure, but trails are closed. So, second choice. I'll read to you from my first book, Take Only Pictures. It's a story where Christine is going to the High Sierra. She hasn't been for quite a while. And she's returned this summer, and there's this wildlife biologist that kind of has her attention, but she's been trying mightily to resist the temptation over the course of the summer. One of her dilemmas is that her dad really wants her to take over their mule ranch and she'd rather be a photographer. So that's a little bit of this scene, but otherwise I think that's all you need to know to jump into this scene about halfway through. Gloria glanced over and saw Christine holding a greeting card. "You bought one of mine," she said, meeting Gloria's eyes. "A bunch, actually. I've been sending my mom's letters in them." "I'm flattered," Christine said. "This is one of my favorites. I was on my first solo trip down to Island Crossing and my horse had a loose shoe. I didn't want to risk it on the Granite Pass, so I was trying to pry it off. These women came up and chatted with me. It hit me the minute I saw them that they were a couple. There was this energy between them, this sense of happiness that they just radiated. I couldn't help but feel it. You can't tell in this shot, but I think about it every time I look at it." "That's funny," Gloria said. "I sense the same thing about them too." She was tempted to add how she pictured herself happily following Christine on the same trail. Christine set the card back down on the counter. "All the stuff in the store is so old. I have other pieces with me at the cabin if you need more. I like your work, the angles you find. They've got a really personal feel to them. I used to have my eye on the landscape all the time. Now I find myself drawn to people." Christine's words surprised Gloria. She turned, wiping her hands on a dish towel, studying Christine, worried that it was her own thoughts that had her reading more into Christine's words than she intended. Christine quieted too. They stood nearly opposite each other in the small quarters. Gloria wondered if Christine was aware of her provocative pose. She leaned back against the counter, her elbows bearing her weight, her long jean-clad legs stretched out in front of her and crossed at the ankles. Gloria took a deep breath, finding it difficult to keep her eyes off Christine's breasts, the fabric of her sweatshirt pulled taut by her posture. She decided Christine's last statement needed clarification. "You're drawn to people in terms of photography." Christine's eyes were on Gloria's mouth when she answered, "Yes." "Not drawn to as in interested in?" "No." Gloria tried to hide her disappointment by turning back to the dishes, but Christine grabbed her hand, stilling her. "Not to people. Just one person. Just you." Relief flooded through Gloria. "Good, because it's been getting harder and harder not to kiss you," she said, putting a foot on either side of Christine's crossed boots. "Is that so?" Gloria's breath caught when Christine took hold of her hips and pulled them to her own. She straightened, surprised by Christine's action and needing to see her eyes. The hesitation she usually read there was replaced completely with desire. She waited a few heartbeats, giving Christine ample time to move away if she needed to, before she leaned forward and kissed the lips that she'd been dreaming about for weeks. She lost herself in the give of Christine's lips and the inviting warmth and softness. Christine's lips parted, summoning more. Gloria ran the tip of her tongue along Christine's bottom lip, smiling at the groan her movement elicited. She tested again and met Christine's tongue with her own. With a sharp intake of breath, Christine pushed away from the counter, standing to reclaim her height advantage. Her right hand swept behind Gloria's neck, fingers playing with the wisps of hair that had escaped Gloria's ponytail as she hungrily deepened the kiss. "I've been thinking about the way that would feel since the last time we stood in a kitchen together," Christine said. "And?" Gloria said, tilting her chin up. "So much better." Christine kissed along Gloria's neck before reclaiming her lips. Gloria reciprocated and ran her own hands into Christine's thick hair, pulling her closer and losing herself in the rush of pure pleasure as Christine's hands explored her contours. She loved Christine's playfulness. Her kisses changed quickly, like an unfamiliar trail, where every turn brings a new and wonderful view. Gloria felt as if she was running to keep up. Reluctantly, she pulled away to catch her breath. She regretted her decision immediately when she felt Christine's hands leave her body. She grabbed for Christine's hands, holding her put. "Don't go. If I stay one kiss longer, I'll be here all night." "And that's a bad thing," Gloria said, wanting Christine to know that she didn't want to push her. "Not bad," Christine said. "There are just things that you're working on." "I know," Gloria said, when the silence lengthened. Christine nodded, pulling her into a tight embrace. "Trust me, you're making it very difficult to leave." Gloria grabbed onto Christine's belt buckle to make it even harder for her. She ran her thumb across the 20-mule team printed on it. "What is it with cowboys and their belt buckles? They're kind of ridiculous." "Sexy," Christine purred, kicking up one eyebrow and cocking a hip. Gloria laughed at Christine's pose and swatted her away. If she wasn't staying, she didn't get to tease. "That's all I have time for. I'm going to see if the trails are going to open anytime soon. I hope to see you there. Be safe. I'll catch you on the trail."